Hill.
Hello, Luke. How are you?
I am fine, sir, by the grace of God.
Luke, what is the honor of your visit worth to me? I don't think I called you.
Please, Mr. CEO, you did not call me. I came to see you in relation to some news that I have just learned concerning a problem with accounting. It seems that you called the accountant but he traveled. I came to offer you my help. Because it's my specialty.
Yes, it's true, Luke. The accountant has traveled and can only be there in 2 months. If the problem is not resolved, the company and its annexes will be idle for 2 months. And we're going to lose millions of dollars.
Oh? It is not possible. Society is going to have very serious problems.
Yes, society is going to have very serious problems.
Don't worry, sir. It'll be okay. God will help us find the source of the problem and correct what is wrong. I think I may help.
Oh, really? Are you sure? Is it true what you're telling me?
Yes, Mr. CEO.
Okay, thank you very much, Luke. Let's go straight to the accounting department.
Okay, Mr. CEO. Hello, Madam Secretary.
Hello, Luke. How are you doing?
I'm doing very well. I give glory to God. And you? How are you doing?
I'm also doing very well, thank you. How is the work in the accounting department?
Madam, it hasn't been easy, but I give glory to God. Everything is back to normal by the grace of God.
The boss is here. Really, thank you for the work you did. The boss is in his office.
Okay, I'll go see him. See you later.
See you later.
Hello, Mr. CEO.
Hello, Lucho, how are you doing?
I am doing very well, Yuji, by the grace of God. I came to tell you that the problem has been resolved. It hasn't been easy at all, but I give all the glory to God. Everything was in total disarray. I don't know if we typed a password multiple times or one word in place of another. In any case, everything is back to normal. I have checked the calculations and figures based on the documents you gave me. Everything is fine. I have sent the results to your computer. There was no fraud or embezzlement. We learned some computer skills in accounting, so that if there is a problem and the IT guy isn't there, you can do the work yourself. But when it's more complicated, you have to call the technician.
I am very happy. I saw the documents on my computer. I'll read them later. You really are very intelligent and talented. Really, thank you very much. You worked fewer days than the one who often comes to do our work.
All the glory is to God. It is the Holy Spirit who has done this work.
Tell me, Luke, when will you tell me about Jesus? I want to know him. I have seen many things in you that compel me to know him and also adore him like you.
Yuji, please call me when you are available.
Okay, I will do it. You know, Luke, I would like to appoint you as deputy director, head of the accounting department. If I'm not here, you'll take my place. I discovered many things in you. You are an exceptional young man. It's rare to find someone like you these days. The signature forgery was just a test. The first day you walked into my office, I felt complete peace. My heart has completely turned to you. Luke, I love you. I would like you to become my son. I don't have any children and I want with all my heart to adopt you. I will put your name on everything that belongs to me. I'm proud of you, Luke. I would like to worship and serve your God. Your God will be my God. I will serve him and worship him like you. You should never change.
Please, Mr. CEO, I am overwhelmed by everything you have just told me. I lack words to speak. I thank God for all these blessings in my life. I thank you very much for the trust you place in me. I was really touched when you talked about adoption, because I never knew my dad and it was my mother alone who raised me. I don't know what led you to talk about adoption, because you don't know anything about my private life. I can't tell you anything now about adoption. I need to talk to God and my mother about this. I bless the Lord for you have decided to give your life to him. May all praise go to God for his mercy, grace and faithfulness.
Luke, I'm going to prepare all the nomination papers. You will earn $15,000 per month and you will have 2 cars at your disposal for your travels. Fuel will be provided to you by the company. If God approves the adoption, you will move into my biggest villa. You will change your clothes before going home and you will also take your car, the one you like. Do you have a driver license?
Yes, Luigi. Words fail me to express my joy. God is faithful. Truly God's faithfulness is demonstrated in our obedience. Jesus is good.
Luke, can I worship God and serve Him? I want to give my life to Jesus.
Yes, boss. Jesus died for the salvation of the world. He came to pay the price for our sins. He came to reconcile us with God. If you believe in Him and give your life to Him, you will be saved.
Okay, I understand. I would like to give Him my life.
Say this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, I thank You for the sacrifice You made for me so that I could be saved. I confess my sins and I beg for the forgiveness of my sins. Wash me with Your precious blood. I receive You today as my personal Lord and Savior. Write my name in the book of life. Rule over my life and help me to obey You in Jesus' name. Amen.
Lord Jesus, I thank You for the sacrifice You made for me so that I could be saved. I confess my sins and I beg for the forgiveness of my sins. Wash me with Your precious blood. I receive You today as my personal Lord and Savior. Write my name in the book of life. Rule over my life and help me to obey You in Jesus' name. Amen.
DG, after that in the afternoon you will take your water baptism. Because the Bible says Mark 16:16, whoever believes and is baptized will be saved, but whoever does not believe will be condemned.
It is as if I have been freed from a great burden. I feel an inexplicable peace and joy deep within me. What happiness. Thanks, Luke.
Let's give all the glory to God. This recognition belongs to Jesus, because it is He who sacrificed Himself for you. Today you are a child of God and your name is written in the book of life. God has become your Father.
I am very happy.
Please, DG, if there's nothing left, I think I'll leave.
No, you're not going back. This day is a special day in my life. We'll go buy clothes and everything you need. Then we will go to eat at the restaurant. Before you go home, you'll come home in a suit and a car.
Okay, I understand, boss. Dear mom, how are you?
Luke, my son, what is happening? Where do you come from with these clothes? You didn't leave dressed like that.
Mom, God is amazing. The Holy Spirit is good. I will always let myself be led by the Holy Spirit. I will submit to Him all my life.
Luke, what happened?
I was appointed deputy director and head of the accounting department. I will earn $15,000 per month, and I have two cars at my disposal. Fuel is provided by the company. If the DG isn't there, it's me who takes control of the companies down to the agencies.
My son, God is all-powerful and faithful. Words fail me to sing of the fidelity and love of God. When you obey God, He manifests His power to honor His promises. When you let yourself be led by the Holy Spirit, He brings you into God's perfect plan. I give all the glory to God and bless the Holy Spirit for His work. I am filled with joy.
Mom, I'm so happy I can't speak. Mom, guess what he said again? You can't believe it. He wants to adopt me. He wants to make me his son. It's really great, but the last word belongs to God, because we don't do anything without His will. We live and walk according to the Holy Spirit.
My son, God approves of adoption. This plan comes from God. Oh well, how do you know, Mom? God spoke to me about it 15 years ago. I wrote it in my notebook. Because I have the habit of writing everything the Holy Spirit tells me in a notebook so that I don't forget and do something else. In difficult times, I reread all these promises in order to be strengthened and to stand firm. Sometimes I remind them to God. I tell myself that the one who made these promises to me is not a man, but He is God and He can never lie. God is faithful, no matter how long it takes. The promises will surely be fulfilled. My son, it hasn't been easy raising you, taking care of you alone. I went through some very difficult times with you. I was abandoned and rejected by everyone. The Holy Spirit encouraged me, strengthened me. He never abandoned me. It is a very great blessing to have intimacy with the Holy Spirit. God sent us the Holy Spirit so as not to leave us orphans. The Holy Spirit is our comforter, a faithful friend. When you wait on God with all your heart and are firm in your decisions, He shakes us. I was everyone's laughing stock, but today, I am the mother of the deputy CEO and head of the accounting department.
Glory to God. Mom, thank you for everything you have done for me. I will fill you with joy. I don't want you to remember all this past suffering. Today, God has rewritten a new story for our lives. I'll take you on vacation when I'm off.
Thank you, my son. God bless you. I am proud of you. Seeing you, I am very happy. I realize how faithful and great God is.
Mom, today I met an acquaintance of Francis who told me that Francis is arrested. He has been in prison for 6 months.
What, Francis? What did he do?
Mom, I don't know. I will go see him to be aware of this whole affair.
Okay, my son, I understand, but we must start interceding for him and imploring God's grace for him.
Okay, Mother dear, I understand. I'm going to go and rest because it's been a very busy day for me.
You do not eat?
No, my beloved mother. I ate with the DG at the restaurant.
Okay, have a good rest, my darling.
Thanks, Mom.
Hello, Deputy DG.
Hello, Madam Secretary. How are you? What can I do for you?
I'm doing very well, Deputy DG. I'm here to remind you of your programs for the week.
Okay, thank you. I'm listening.
Tomorrow, you have a working meeting with all the companies we work with. The day after tomorrow, you will attend the conference organized at the Star Hotel for the world's accountants. That's it for the programs. One of our resident partners in Dubai called you.
Okay, thank you, Secretary. Regarding the Dubai partner, I will call him later. I have to go out right away. If someone asks me, I'll come. See you later.
Okay, I understand, Deputy DG.
Hello, my beloved Francis. Hello, Luke. I did not listen to the Holy Spirit. I disobeyed God. I made my own choice. Look where I am now. I believed myself to be wiser and more intelligent than the Holy Spirit. What am I going to do now? I wasted my life. No, your life is not ruined yet. God is love and He is capable of anything. Calm down. We're going to talk. You're going to tell me concretely what's going on. Luke, I ask your forgiveness. I offended you. I made fun of you. I denigrated you. Forgive me, I beg you. It's okay, my brother. Everyone can make mistakes. Don't worry. I forgave you, otherwise I wouldn't be here with you. Now tell me what's going on. The company was already bankrupt before I started the job. Someone used my signature to take money from the company without me knowing. I've been here 6 months. May God help me. May the Holy Spirit shed light on this matter. I bitterly regret what I did. If I had listened to the Holy Spirit, I would not be here. I don't even know how long I will spend here. That God forgives me. I will never do it again. No matter what I'm going through, I'm going to surrender to the Holy Spirit. Luke, pray for me. May God forgives me. May the Holy Spirit not abandon me. God can never abandon or reject His child. God says, though the mountains move away and the hills shake, my love will not depart from you, and my covenant of peace will not be shaken. In Jeremiah 32 verse 3, God says that His love for you is eternal and infinite, which is why He preserves His tenderness for you. God's love for you is unchanging. God does not love you according to your good or bad deeds. God's love for you is constant. No matter your sins, your mistakes, He doesn't change. God knew all the mistakes you were going to make when He saved you. You don't surprise Him and know that when you ask God for forgiveness, He forgives you and forgets. Don't blame yourself. Don't condemn yourself. It's the devil who accuses and condemns. Trust God. No matter your mistakes, God will get you out of this situation because He is love. You are His child and He loves you. Mom and I are going to pray for you. I will also discuss with my father and we will see what we can do for you according to God's will. My brother of courage, God loves you and me too. Know that He is with you. Thank you very much, Luke, for your visit, your support and others. May God bless you and keep you. Amen, my brother. The Lord by His grace transformed my situation. We will have time to chat. I will leave you. I have to go to work. Be well and my heart goes out to you. Don't hesitate to ask me anything you need here. I'm here for you. I thank you, my brother. Thank you very much. Your visit did me good. As for the change in your situation, I noticed it when I saw you. I give glory to God for that. I wanted to get ahead of God, that's what brought me here. It's okay, it's going to be okay. I leave you. Goodbye, Francis. Goodbye, Luke. May God protect you.
Hello, my son. How are you?
Hello, Dad. I am fine by the grace of God. And you, how are you doing?
I give glory to God. I am also very well. Where were you? I called you in vain. I asked the secretary if she knew your position. She told me you were out.
Dad, I'm sorry for not warning you before leaving. I went to see Francis in prison. My friend I told you about.
Oh yes, you saw him? What is the problem? It's serious.
Dad, please, we'll discuss it later. I'll come see you at your office.
Okay, fine, I get it. Luke, we'll go out to eat together this evening. I'm counting on you to come with your mother.
Okay, I understand, Dad, there is no problem. Dad, I have some urgent matters to deal with. There is also our partner from Dubai who called and whom I have to call back.
Okay, my son, understood. I will let you work. See you later. I am proud of you and I love you very much.
Dad, I'm proud of you too. I love you, Dad.
Lynette, how did you like the evening? I hope you liked it.
Yes, Daniel, I really liked it. I thank you for this invitation.
It's me who thanks you for accepting my invitation. You have no idea how much you have filled me this evening with your presence by my side. Lynette, you are very beautiful. You are truly a special woman. Every man would like to have you as his wife. You are very intelligent and wise. Thank you for the education you gave to Luke, my son. Despite everything you went through because of your pregnancy, you held on until the end. You are a determined and accomplished woman.
Thank you for all the praise. But know that without the Holy Spirit, I can do nothing. All the glory is to the Holy Spirit. I give glory to the Holy Spirit for all He has done for you. You know, Lynette, if I wanted us to be together tonight, it's because I have something to tell you. I've known you for 2 years and Luke became my son. Lynette, I love you and I want you to be my wife.
I want to spend the rest of my life by your side. What do you say? Would you marry me?
You know, Daniel, I was waiting for this day, a long time ago. Because the Holy Spirit spoke to me about it. I want to become your wife. I love you too. I am very happy.
Thank you for agreeing to become my wife. You make me the happiest man.
Me too, Daniel. You make me the happiest woman. God has promised that He will take away my reproach, that He will wipe away my tears. I give Him all the glory. He did beyond my expectations. These two promises, Luke's adoption and my marriage, came true after 15 years of waiting. I bless the Lord for His goodness and faithfulness. Daniel, my darling, it hasn't been easy for me at all. There were times of hunger, shame, humiliation, denigration, insomnia, tears, terrible shortages, but I give honor to God who did not abandon my son and me. My wonder doesn't think about all these things anymore. I will fill you with happiness. Thank you, Daniel. Thank you, my love.
It's my duty, my darling. I love you.
I love you too, my dear. Luke, my son, God is truly wonderful. He changed the story of our lives.
May all the glory go to Him. I will exalt you, O my God, my King, and I will bless your name forever and ever. I will bless you daily and celebrate your name forever and ever. The Lord lifts up all those who fall and straightens up all those who are bowed down. The eyes of all hope in you, and you give them food in due time. Thank you, God, I lack words to say thank you. You have removed my shame, my reproach. You took me from the mud to make me sit at the table of kings. From zero that I was, you made me a heroine.
Thank you, Father, you are faithful. Glory and honor to you in the name of Jesus, amen. Amen, amen.
Mom, I'm very happy. God is so wonderful.
How are you feeling, my beautiful and splendid wife? I feel good, my darling.
I am so happy and moved that I cannot find adequate words to say thank you to God. Daniel, can you imagine Lynette sitting on a plane in first class to go on vacation? Who can imagine this? Even if God came down and told the people, they would not believe it. God took me from the mud, from the waste to make me sit at the table of kings. God has washed me, clothed me, and honored me. God has written a new and wonderful story for my life. God is faithful, me who knocked on doors left and right to eat, dress and take care of my son. I was nicknamed all sorts of names. Shame was my food. I couldn't even lift my head wherever I passed. I did small jobs left and right to take care of Luke. I had to throw away my things to meet our needs. I could no longer dress myself and take care of my beauty. My child and I were rejected and abandoned by the person who impregnated me, his entire family, and even my family. When night came, I wondered when daylight would come. And when it was daytime, I wondered when will it be dark. At a point in my life, I no longer knew what we called sleeping. I experienced God, I met Him in my distress, I saw His faithfulness. I give Him all the glory. I trusted Him, and He helped me and helped me. I am proud and honored to be God's daughter. His infinite and deep love for me has been my strength and the pillar that has sustained me. I love you, O Almighty God, my loving dad. You are my all in all. You are my refuge, my succor and my help in distress. My dear, God says in Isaiah 62 verse 2, then the nations will see your salvation, and all kings your glory, and you will be called by a new name that the mouth of the Lord will determine. He also tells you in Isaiah 43 verse 18, think no more about past events and consider no more what is old.
It's over, my darling. God has opened another chapter in the book of your life. Forget past chapters and let's rejoice together in this new season we have entered. I love you.
I love you too, Daniel. My dear, I forgot to tell you that Francis was released yesterday. The culprit was arrested.
Oh well, it's wonderful. Glory to God, I'm really very happy.
Brothers and sisters, that's it all for this video. If you liked this video, feel free to like it, comment and share around you so that many souls be saved and restored. And don't forget to subscribe to the Sentinel channel so you don't miss any of our upcoming videos. God bless you.